Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. I am Vikas Nitzer. In today's video, we are going to see how to find out IDFT without using inbuilt command. So let's start. So just write find inverse discrete Fourier transform without using inbuilt command. That inbuilt command is nothing but IFFT. Okay. Now let's start. Simply I will take input 2 comma 1 minus 1 I comma 0 comma 1 plus 1 I square bracket complete. Then I will write a function file. Output argument is nothing but out equal to your function name is nothing but IDFT, and in bracket I will take input as A. Then I have to, for this function I have to write a program, a function program, because here I have written the function, that is IDFT. So I have to write output argument, that is nothing but out. Function name is nothing but IDFT, and here I will take, initially I have taken the A as input, so initially I will take here IN. Here I have taken A, so basically I will take as IN as A, input argument in a function. Now I will write, let's say N equal to length of input, it will find the length. Then we know that in IDFT or DFT, whatever the sequence is there, that always from N, start from N minus 1, so I will define N minus 1. Then I will take a 0 in a D, because that required for a next step. Then I will take an empty matrix, again it is required for next step. For loop, we know that in DFT, IDFT, whatever the DFT we find or IDFT we find, that always from 0 to N1, because the value of N1 is nothing but N minus 1. Initially that value is from 0 to N minus 1, but already the N minus 1 we have taken into the N1. Then I will write for is equal to I is equal to 0 as to N1. Second, now I will write the program for IDFT for using a total factor formula. So I will write IN 1 comma I plus 1 bracket complete into exponential of J into 2 into pi into I into K bracket complete divided by capital N bracket complete semicolon. So simply it will take a values from 0 to n1, means n minus 1, 1 by 1. For each value of I, it will calculate the value of G. So like this, it will calculate the summation. Now I will take that D is equal to, initially value of D is 0. So whatever the value calculated into the G, that value you can take into the D. Okay, so D plus G, then. So we know that in IDFT formula, there is only one difference between DFT and IDFT. There is a e raised to plus j, in DFT having e raised to minus j, and again there is one difference. Whatever the summation you got, that summation you have to divide by the 1 by n. So now I will divide D divided by capital N. Now I will make end of first for loop, and finally again I will make that D should be a 0. Then I will combine all the matrix. So for that I have to write, that is EMP, that is empty matrix in bracket, summation So for each value it will add into that matrix one by one. Again there is an end for the second for loop, and I will take that matrix into the out argument. So out is equal to emp. That's it. Okay, again whatever the value you got, again that value I can make round off that value. So for that in main program I will write that is a round off output. So it will make a round off that values. Okay, so simply once again I will save this file. We have written a function, so you have to save this file into same folder. So I will save with the same name. Okay, again save AF record. Okay, for function file it will save that program with a function name, that is nothing but IDFT that we have taken. Okay, now see here, once again here we have taken input, we have taken a function, A is the input argument. Okay, that for that function I have written the program here. Okay, out as in output argument, in as input, that in is nothing but A. Then we have taken a length of that, then we have defined the maximum length is n minus 1, then we have defined the initially empty values for the matrix, then we have defined the k equal to 0 to n1, I is equal to 0 to n1, then we taken the total factor formula to calculate the summation, that we have taken into the d. Again that values are divided by n, because in IDFT that total summation is divided by n, again is end. Finally again I have done that d is equal to 0, and the next thing, whatever the value you got, that values I have taken into empty matrix, so you will get an actual final matrix. And finally again whatever that matrix is there, that matrix I have taken into out. Again that out function I have taken round, means I have taken the round of that out value. Now simply click on the run option. Okay, now you can check the output. So you can see, okay, you can see the all values, n equal to 4, empty matrix, initial the first value in a matrix is 1, in first we got 1, this value, in second case this 1, this is the third one, the fourth one, and this is the output, and finally you will get a round off value. This is actual matrix, this is the actual matrix, but after you take the round of that, so you will get 1100. So this is nothing but output sample. Simply you can make copy of this onto Word file and you can take a printout of this. So that's it. Okay, so this is the most important program in MATLAB for signal processing. So without, initially we know that how to find out DFT, IDFT using inbuilt command, that is a very easy thing, but you can also find out the DFT, IDFT without using a inbuilt command. So I hope you will like this video. If you like, then please subscribe my channel, comment on my channel and share my channel. Thank you all of you.